Today I'm going to show you how I make a cushion cover.
I'm going to be making a cushion. I've got my zipper cut out and assembled. I've got my boxing, my top and bottom, and my cording. So now we'll start assembling.
So I begin with my boxing on the bottom and then my cushion piece on top, and I'm going to put my cording in between them. Get it under the presser foot, and I always start on one of the front corners. Go across the front and down to the back. Holding both pieces together, watching to make sure my fabric's not slipping. So I've got my cording, my boxing, and my top of my cushion all sandwiched together. When I get almost to the corner, I go in a half an inch from the end of the cushion and make a snip to help my cushion go around the corner, or to help my cording go around the corner. And I'll stop, lift the presser foot, and pivot the top of the cushion so I get a nice square corner. I'm only going to go into about here because this is where I will then attach my zipper. So I've stopped and got my boxing out of the way, but I'm going to continue attaching the cording. So then when I put the zipper on, the cording's already down. Stop short of the end so I can join my cording pieces together when I come in from the other direction. So this is the top of my cushion. We've sewn the boxing across the front, matching our stripes. We've come around to the back corner, and I've brought the boxing around a little bit and stopped there with the boxing, but continued the cording. Now what I'll do is come in from the other front corner and come down and meet the two cordings together, and then we'll put our zipper on. Okay, now I'm back where I started from in the first place and going in the other direction. Now you'll notice my boxing is on top and my cushion is under, cushion top is underneath. And again, I'm coming to the corner, so I'm gonna snip in about a half an inch so that we can pivot when we get there. Keeping the needle in, lifting my presser foot, pivot the fabric, turn my cording. It's a little more awkward on this side than it is on the other side. Holding the three layers together again. And now we continue. Again, I'm close to the end, so I'm going to go back in that half an inch, clip into the corner. Now I'm going to need to join my cordings, so I go a little bit further. Now we'll be joining the two cordings together. So I'm going to trim this one down, get a nice straight edge. Lay the two side by side. I'm going to cut back here about 2.5 inches, 3 inches maybe. Now open the top cording up. The stitches open them back up beyond the bottom cording. Okay, so now I've got it opened up beyond that cording. Keep my cording ends together, so I'm going to snip this cording off out of the fabric. So I've cut the cord out. Now I'm going to lay this fabric underneath here, fold it up on a diagonal. So I've got a diagonal line. Bring this one inside. Take some maneuvering with your fingers sometimes. Butt the two ends up to each other. Roll this back over the top. Now you want to be careful that your underneath piece, if I can find it here, is where you want it and doesn't sneak in, so that that cording is all sandwiched in there. And then I'll start sewing. So there you see, we have a nice neat joint. Now we're ready to put our zipper in. I've pinned it in place where I want it to be. And you can see I've got a little bit of fabric on each end that are gonna lay over the top of this when it's on the right side. So that's difficult to explain, but easier to show. So we'll bring it. So now I'll bring the fabric around where I'm gonna sew it, and then I'm gonna bring it to the machine. Now we'll do the same thing at the other end of the zipper, joining it to the boxing. Sometimes your fingers don't want to work. Bringing it to the machine. So now we've sewn the one side of the zipper. And as you'll see when I flip it over, we have a little area that's hung over the top of the zipper so that it hides the slide. And we've got the same thing at both ends. Makes the ends look nicer. Now what I'm going to do is mark the other side of the corner on the boxing so that when I'm doing the second side I can line up those corners. I do it by just doing a little V-snip. And I'll do that in each corner. So here we've got the other side of our cushion and our cording. And the first half that we've already sewn with our corners marked. Now what I will do is line up the corners. So I'll put my cording down. I've got a little snip there to tell me that's where I wanted the corner. And I'll put the corner notch about a half inch in from the corner of the bottom piece of fabric. So as you can see here, this is my bottom of my cushion. This is my boxing from the sewn to the top. And you've got my notch. I want my notch about a half inch in from the corner so that when I turn the corner on this end, it'll be right there. So hold those pieces together and start sewing. So I get about half to three quarters of the way across, and now I'm going to check my other corner just to see how we're doing, and it looks pretty good. Snip my cording and pivot again. Make sure you get all your different layers laid in here nicely before you sew them together. Now I'm checking the lining up of my corners and they're still looking good. Snip my cording. Okay, I've pivoted around the corner. And we're getting to where we're going to have to join cording again. Now we'll serge all the edges and then turn it right side out.
Please subscribe, and if you wouldn't mind, leave a comment on my videos.
So we've stuffed the cushion, and here's your completed cover. The zipper.